Now that we discussed the inception phase, let's move to the second phase of RUP, which is the elaboration phase. And there are four main goals and activities for the elaboration phase: analyzing the problem domain to get a better understanding of the domain, establishing a solid architectural foundation for the project, eliminating the highest risk elements, which basically means addressing the most critical use cases, and finally, refine the plan of activities and estimates of resources to complete the project. The outcome of the elaboration phase reflects these activities and also in this case produces several artifacts. The first one is an almost complete use case model with all use cases and actors identified and most use case descriptions developed. As part of this phase, we also identify a set of what we call supplementary requirements. So these are basically all the requirements that are not associated with the use case. And this set includes, in particular, all non-functional requirements, such as security, reliability, maintainability, and so on. So all the ones that are relevant for the system that you're developing. We mentioned before that the software architecture is developed in an incremental way, so it's not created at once. And this is exactly what happens in the elaboration phase, that we take the initial architecture that was defined in the inception phase, and we refine it until we get to a software architecture which is complete. And that is part of the deliverables for this phase. And the list continues, so let me make some room. In addition to producing a complete architecture for our system, in the elaboration phase, we also define the lower level design for the system. And therefore, as part of this phase, we produce as deliverables a design model, and together with that, a complete set of test cases and an executable prototype. We also produce a revised project plan. Now that we have more information about the project, we can refine the various estimates and the various pieces of information in the project plan, and also an updated risk assessment document. Finally, in this phase, we also generate a preliminary user manual that describes to the users how the system can be used and should be used. So now let's see what are the evaluation criteria for the elaboration phase, which is our second milestone. So I'm just going to list them here. The first one is whether the vision and the architecture are stable or they're still changing. So did we converge into a final complete vision for the system? Does the prototype show that the major risks that we have identified have been resolved or at least addressed in this phase? Is the project plan sufficiently detailed and accurate? Do all stakeholders agree that the vision can be achieved with the current plan? Is the actual resource expenditure versus the planned expenditure acceptable? So now we started consuming resources, and therefore we can check whether our estimates were correct. And also in this case, the project might be cancelled or considerably reshaped if it fails to pass this milestone.